Three, two, one, go. Hello everyone, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. This is the part two of the prediction of the Bitcoin price using deep learning model, and you can see that I have the code in front of me. And in the last video on Sunday, we posted this video where we made this model, LSTM based model. You can see that these are the model training results over this. And now in this video, I'm going to use this model to make the actual prediction and make a graph of prediction versus the actual prices. So let's go. Just to give a very, very brief idea, we actually used 12 data API in the last video to extract the prices. We used 5 minutes interval. We trained the model using 2 hours of recurring data, and then we are predicting the next hour price of Bitcoin. We used LSTM model for this one, and the libraries that we have used are all this one. And this was the quiz in the last video. You can still write your option in the comment section below. Let's see how many of you guys actually know the correct answer. So guys, the way we actually extracted the Bitcoin prices using 12 data API, like this one, we actually use an API key over there, and then we did all those things. We made the API URL, and then finally we used a request library to get the final prices. If you remember, I said this thing in my last video, is that I'm actually keeping from 20th to 23rd prices as my reserve for my testing purpose, and that's why actually I didn't train it on that data, because it's not a good activity, it's not a good procedure to actually train and test data on the same data set. And that's why actually I didn't use any of those data for the training purposes. Now I have actually made the same way, which is test start and test end, and now I'm using it from 20th of October to 23rd of October, right? It's the same API URL over there. I'm using a request library and then using the final pd.data frame to get to the final test data final. You can see that we have another data frame in front of us of Bitcoin prices from 20th of October to 23rd of October. We have 855 rows with us and 5 columns, and I'll be just using this close column for this purpose. So let's see what is the closing price of this. So this, and then if I do it like this, the close is like you can see it's a pandas series. The only issue is that it's in the object format. I'll have to convert it into the float format, and that was actually the quiz. So yeah, I'm going to use it like this. So pd dot to numeric, like this. So if we run it, you can see that it has converted the type into float. Now I'm just interested in values. Perfect. So we have all the values now in front of us. Let's call this as Bitcoin prices. These are the actual values of Bitcoin, right? So I'll be using this to plot the graph. Now these are the actual prices. Now we will have to get the predicted prices as well, so that we have both Bitcoin prices and the predicted prices in the graph. So for that, let's write test inputs is equal to test data final and then close dot values. Now if you remember the way I actually did it for the training the model, I'll have to reshape into two dimensions, and in this case I'm actually using np dot reshape, or actually we can do it like this, test inputs dot reshape -1,1. If you are confused about all these things, just watch my last video. Actually I did all these things in my previous video as well, like you can see over here. So I'm just doing the same things here for the test data as well. Now model inputs will be, imagine what, like we'll have to squeeze the data right into between 0 and 1. So scalar dot transform, what is scalar, by the way? Scalar is this one, which will be required to squeeze the data between 0 and 1, as we did for the training purpose, right? So it will be between 0 and 1, right? So we have already provided this thing, which is 0 and 1. I'll have to provide test inputs here. Now if we see what is the model inputs, you can see all the data is being squeezed to squeeze between 0 and 1, right? And if we just write dot shape, it should be something comma 1, which is 855 comma 1, right? Perfectly, exactly as we want. Now let's make an x test the way we made the x train, right? For x in range, time interval to train, comma len of model inputs this time, x test dot append, and then we need model inputs. Again, it's exactly the same thing, which is x minus time interval, time intervals to train, comma, and then from there to x, comma zero. So again, like we're actually making a list of multiple arrays with the length of 24, right? The same way we did for x train. Now we will convert x test into an array because it's a list right now. And then what next? Just guess. We'll have to reshape into three dimensions because this is how we will be using the LSTM model. So everything is actually repetitive. X test, and then we need to provide x test com dot shape 0 comma x test dot shape 1 comma 1, and that's it. So now we have x test. If I just write dot shape, by the way guys, shape is one of the most important things to check in a deep learning model, because this is I would say the most common error that people used to make. There are different types of shapes that are required to make any particular model, and we'll have to actually follow that thing. So we have to use np.reshape again and again in this types of model. So you can see that it's a three-dimensional model right now, a three-dimensional np array, numpy array right now in front of us with 831 entries in this direction, and then 24 into another dimension. We have the third dimension, which is just one. Now let's predict the price. Prediction prices is equal to model predict and then x test, as simple as that. Now let me just do one thing. If I run this cell, you can see that the prices that are predicted are also between 0 and 1. We don't want prices to be between 0 and 1 now, because we want the actual price that will be compared with the actual Bitcoin prices, right? So I'll have to use inverse fit transform, scalar dot inverse transform, and that's just the prediction prices, right? If I run this, and then after that, if I run this one, you can see that all the prediction are in front of you. It's float format, so it will be easy. There won't be any issue to plot these prices. Perfect. So we have our predicted prices as well. Now, two things are remaining for in this video. Now I'll plot the graph now, and then second thing is we will predict the next our price, right? So this is all about the model. Now what is the next price that is going to happen after 1 hour or so, right? So we'll do this thing, two things after plotting the graph, right? So for plotting the graph, I just need plt.plot. I've already imported matplotlib, right? So Bitcoin prices, let's make the label to be equal to Bitcoin prices. plt.plot. Now I want prediction prices, label equal to predicted prices. I just provided the name, the title also, which is predicting Bitcoin prices, and then x label is 5 minutes and time interval, and y label is price. Now I just want plt.legend to show the final legends, and then plt.show. Perfect. So we have got the final graph. Okay, interesting. More or less it's the same, but you can see that our orange line, which is the predicted price, has predicted an upward movement much before the actual upward movement. So you can see it's on the left hand side, so it has gone up before the actual Bitcoin prices went up. And then similarly, when it the orange line went down before the Bitcoin prices went down, and similarly again it went up before Bitcoin prices went up, and so on. So yeah, you can see here also. So it's amazing. It's amazing. Actually, it has a very good accuracy. And if someone has run this model at this moment of time, you can see that the orange line is very below the actual blue line. And at this time, you should have sold Bitcoin and actually went down significantly. I'm not 100% sure about the viability of this model, but I can see that by just looking at this graph, you can see it's a very good prediction in this one. Maybe in future I'll keep on working on this one, and I'll see what more, I would say, advancements can we make in this particular model. But actually, I'm very happy with this one now. Now let's predict the next 1 hour Bitcoin price, right? Actually, it won't be predicting the next 1 hour. I'll be predicting the next price after this one. So what will be the price on 24th 10 2021, and then 1 hour, which is 1:00:00. So the price at that moment of time. So let's see what is the price. So for the last data, I'm just providing last data is equal to, so now we just have one array, and this array will be the last 24, right? So the last 24 is length of the entire model, just plus one, because the next one, and then plus one minus, we'll have to take the time interval, which is time intervals for train, and then we'll have to, from this level, I'll have to go to the last one, which is the length of the model plus one, perfect, comma zero. I'll have to convert it into np.array. Now what next? Just guess, guys. I'm not going forward. Just guess what's the next step. The next step is to reshape. So last data is equal to np.reshape last data comma. Now I just need to get this 24. So I just write a 1 and then last data dot shape. I'm interested in the 0th one, and that's it. So let me just check it. If I just write last data dot shape, it's 23. So I'll have to convert it into three dimensional, right? So it's 1, 23, 1. As simple as that. A prediction is equal to model dot predict and then last data. We can see if I just write prediction again, we'll have to do the inverse transform now. So prediction is equal to scalar dot inverse transform and then prediction. If I write prediction, you can see that the model has predicted that the next 1 hour price should be 60,614.023. Now what's the reliability of this model? This is your work now. This is how we can actually use the deep learning LSTM model to do the prediction of Bitcoin prices. Now you'll get this code for free. Actually, I share my Google Drive with all my subscribers. But before that, if you liked this video, just give me one like on this video and also the last one, and also subscribe to this YouTube channel. It really helps with the algorithm. Also, if you think that you learned something today, and if you want to tip me on the work that I'm actually doing for free to all my lovely subscribers and viewers, you can actually tip me by going to the link which is mentioned in the description box. In euros or USD, you just need to select the number of coffees, and I'll just go outside to drink that coffee on your behalf. So thank you so much for that if you're doing that. In order to get a free access of my Google Drive, where I'll be saving this code, and there are actually many more codes saved over there, such as my trading bot and my other amazing codes, then what you need to do is just subscribe to my YouTube channel and then click on this access to my Google Drive button. Just follow some steps over there and then fill some information, basic details over there, and I'll be using this email address to give a free access of my Google Drive, where I'll be saving this code as well. I hope you like my video and the work that I'm doing for everyone. I'll see you in the next video.